In this video, we will discuss how to use Tenable.io to identify Log4Shell vulnerabilities. Log4Shell is a unique vulnerability because you must use local authenticated Nessus checks, remote unauthenticated Nessus checks, and the Tenable.io web application checks to most effectively identify Log4Shell vulnerabilities in your environment. Using the Tenable.io web application scanner to identify Log4Shell vulnerabilities is outside of the scope of this video. But there is a separate video on the Tenable product education channel that covers this. So be sure to watch that video as well. Tenable.io has multiple scan templates to identify Log4Shell. Of these three Log4Shell scan templates, the Log4Shell vulnerability ecosystem is the most robust and comprehensive. This scan template will conduct local authenticated checks and remote unauthenticated checks. We're expecting many vendor advisories to come in over the coming days and weeks, and the Log4Shell ecosystem scan template will receive these plugins. The other Log4Shell scan templates will not. In fact, this Log4Shell scan template will be deprecated and removed from Tenable.io in favor of the ecosystem scan template. The Log4Shell remote checks scan template consists of our primary remote unauthenticated checks. Although this scan template will move very quickly through your environment, it will not necessarily detect all instances of Log4Shell. The general best practice is to use the Log4Shell vulnerability ecosystem scan template configured with credentials. Let's configure this scan. The first step to configuring the Log4Shell scan is to go ahead and give it a name. The next thing you need to do is set which scanner you want to run the job. If this is an external scan, scanning your internet-facing IP address space, then you would want to use the Tenable.io cloud scanners. If this is an internal scan, scanning your internal environment, then you would want to use one of the linked Nessus scanners or Nessus scanner groups. The next thing you need to do is set your targets. And finally, it's a recommended best practice to go ahead and configure this scan with credentials. You can set both SSH and Windows credentials on this scan. Once all that is complete, you can launch the scan. Now, once the scan results come back, they'll be made available in the Tenable.io Log4Shell dashboard. The most important part of this dashboard is up in the top left here, where we are reporting on the total number of Log4j instances detected, and more importantly, the total number of Log4Shell vulnerabilities confirmed in the environment. I will go ahead and drill into my 6 confirmed Log4Shell vulnerabilities. Here we see the different findings. And I'll go ahead and drill into one of the primary remote unauthenticated checks that fired during the scan. Now on this page, we see a description of the vulnerability, solution for the vulnerability, and also which hosts are affected. We can click output to get a lot of detailed information about the finding. Here you see the exact payloads that Nessus injected into the HTTP headers to confirm the presence of this vulnerability. In addition to unauthenticated checks, we also have the local checks as discussed to identify Log4Shell vulnerabilities. So let's see what those look like. Here we see our affected host. We can click output. And in this plugin output, we see the file path to 2 affected files. The authenticated plugins will also look for Log4Shell vulnerabilities and things like package managers, et cetera. Now you can also change this to a by asset view to get a comprehensive list of all hosts that are vulnerable to Log4Shell. From here, you can also export these results in various different formats to assist with remediation purposes. Finally, I'd like to point you to our dedicated tenable.com/log4j page. This page is updated in real time, so be sure to check it often, as this is a rapidly evolving situation. But on here, you'll be able to find information about from blog posts, information from our research team, and links to product education videos, such as the one that you're watching right now.